In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon his last and beloved messenger Muhammad. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. The title of this presentation is Optimal Solar Collector Design from the Quran. I will show brothers and sisters in this lecture how to get the best design for a device that can harness the energy from the sun by pondering upon the verses of the last revelation of Allah God to people, the Quran, and not by depending on the guesswork of people. And you will see that this design will have an efficiency that is far superior to any known design today. So to begin, if you look at the current designs for solar collectors, as you can see on the screen, this is a sample of a very common solar collector that is used to heat water. Now, these designs, they have many disadvantages. Firstly, that they occupy a lot of area, so they are cumbersome and difficult to implement. And they have a low efficiency. Meaning, for example, if there are 100 units of energy incident from the sun, these collectors, they can harness 20 or 30 out of the 100. So they have a very low efficiency. And this is something that's bad in design. So they have a lot of problems. Now, in this lecture, I will show how by pondering upon the Quran, the words of Allah, God Almighty, Allah would teach us how to design a collector that can harness solar energy with optimal efficiency. So to start, if we ponder upon verse number 38 of chapter 6 of the Quran, which reads, "There is not a moving creature on earth, nor a bear that flies with its two wings, but are communities like you. Allah God has left nothing out from the book, then unto their Lord they shall be gathered." So here Allah God Almighty is telling us in this Quranic verse that He has left nothing out from the book, meaning that this book, the Quran, the last revelation of God to people, it contains the knowledge of everything, that He has left nothing out from it. So in this context, what we are saying, I want to know the best design for a solar collector, I should find it from this book. I should be able to find it from this book, because Allah is telling that He has left nothing out of the book. Let's see how we can learn the best design for a solar collector from the Quran. If we ponder upon verse number 191 of chapter 3 of the Quran, which reads, "Those who remember Allah God standing, sitting, and lying down on their sides, and think deeply about the creation of the heavens and the earth. Our Lord, you have not created this without purpose. Glory to you. Give us salvation from the torment of the fire." So here Allah God Almighty is urging us to think deeply about the creation of the heavens and the earth. So, if we do this and think about what's around us, what Allah God Almighty created, and if we look at plants, now, plants, they harness solar energy to be used in photosynthesis and their biomechanisms. So, as Allah is telling us the Quran to think about what He has created, we did that and we looked at plants. They are basically solar collectors. They harness solar energy to live basically. Now if we link all of this with this Quranic verse in chapter 32 of the Quran, verse 7, which reads, "Who perfected everything He has created, and He began the creation of people from mud." So here Allah is telling us that He perfected everything He has created. This means that plants are optimal solar collectors. So we are looking for an optimal design for a solar collector. We don't have to look anywhere further. Just looking at plants and how Allah, God Almighty, created the plants, we can take ideas from that and implement them in engineering design. So that's how I will proceed, by looking and pondering upon how Allah created the plants, taking ideas from there, and trying to implement these ideas in an engineering design. So to start with, looking at plants, I divided this in steps. Firstly, the general shape of the collector. Now, if you look how Allah created the plants and trees, we see that they go vertical, not horizontal. And this is a major deviation of what people do today. People with collectors, they put them in a horizontal fashion, which takes a lot of space and becomes difficult to implement these large kind of areas of collectors. So the first thing we learn, that our collector that we learn from the Quran should go vertical more than horizontal. And this, it's excellent because it doesn't occupy so much space. It goes vertical in the sky. That's the first thing we learn, that we need to go vertical, not horizontal. Also, if we look at the anatomy of a tree, we see that it's larger at the base than the top. So if you look at leaves of the tree, leaves of the plant, they are the elements that they harness solar energy. We see that they are larger at the base. They occupy a larger kind of circle than the top. So we start getting ideas from the trees. And this is the first kind of idea I thought of, that our collector should be made of rings, let's say rings, and the bottom ring would have a larger diameter of the upper rings. And these rings, they will have elements collecting solar energy, like the leaves in a plant and how they are distributed in a plant. And of course, we need to have a central collector, a central cylinder that will collect the energy harnessed from these rings. For example, if we convert solar energy into electrical, this central collector would collect this electrical energy or hot water or whatever form of energy conversion we do. So as you can see the screen, this is a first kind of idea from the plants for a collector going vertical, composed of rings. These rings will have elements collecting solar energy and having a central collector like the stem of a plant. Okay, let's proceed. Now, looking at these rings will have elements harnessing solar energy. So what are these elements? We don't have to look anywhere further than looking at the plant's leaves, the leaves of a plant. We see that the leaves, they have circular and elliptical shapes more than rectangular shapes. Now, people, depending on their guesswork, they made the collectors rectangular. But when we look at how Allah God Almighty created the leaves, we see that they are circular and elliptical more than rectangular shapes. Why? Because if we look at how energy propagates in creation, we see that it propagates from its source with concentric circles. So the energy coming from the sun, propagating from the sun, it will propagate with concentric circles. Now, the best way to collect these circles if you have the collecting element or the sink, let's say, having the same shape of the energy. So the best way to collect energy propagating in circular fashion, to have a collector having a circular shape, you will have maximum kind of energy harnessing when you have this kind of design. So now we understand why the leaves, they have more circular shapes than rectangular ones. So this is the suggested shape for solar energy collecting elements. So the elements we will use in our collector can be circular, hexagonal, elliptical. Let's say circular. So here's the suggested distribution for these elements. So as I said, we have kind of rings, and within this ring, it will be composed of the shape you see on the screen of discs having circular cross section arranged in this fashion. These are the like the engineering analogy for leaves. So learning from the design of the leaves, how Allah created the leaves, the engineering design like circular discs collecting solar energy. Okay. Now if we look further in plants, we see that Allah God Almighty arranged the leaves on the plant stem that they have a helical arrangement. And this the purpose of this is that it's out of the mercy of Allah God Almighty that the upper leaf will not block the energy coming to the lower leaf. So when you have a helical arrangement, the upper leaf will not block the energy coming to the lower one. So we need to implement this in our collector. How? That this is, let's say, the first ring collecting of our collector having circular discs. The upper ring should have circular discs as well, but they should be shifted like a helical arrangement, not on top of each other. They will have a shift between each other, not to block the sun from the lower ring. So I hope now you are getting the idea of the collector composed of rings. Each ring will be composed of circular discs. The upper ring will have circular discs, smaller in diameter, but shifted such that not to block the energy from the upper ring to the lower one. Okay, now coming to another question. What color should these rings be? What should we paint these discs, these circular discs? What the color? Should it be black, white, yellow? What's the color? If you look at the color Allah God Almighty used for the leaves, we see it's green, dark green, let's say. So that's the question, that's the answer. We need to use dark green as the color for our collector. Why? Because if you look at, this is the a figure showing the frequency and the energy content of incident solar radiation. So on the x-axis, we have the wavelength in nanometer, which corresponds to the frequency of the light coming from the sun. And on the y-axis, we have the energy in watts per meter square. Now, if you look at the wavelength of about 500 nanometers, we see that the photons of light coming from the sun, they have the maximum energy around the 500 nanometer point. And glory be to Allah God Almighty, if you look at the frequency of green light, of green color, we see that the frequency of the green color is also about 500 nanometer. So the maximum energy of the photons coming from the light, from the sun, is about 500 nanometers, the frequency at that energy distribution. And the frequency of the green color is also 500 nanometer. Now the significance of this is that we have here something called resonance. Resonance, it's a phenomenon in physics that you have maximum energy transfer. And it works like if you have an incident energy vibrating a certain frequency and you have the object collecting this energy having a natural frequency at the same frequency of incident radiation, you have maximum energy transfer occurring. So glory be to Allah God Almighty. The color of the leaves, the green color, makes a resonance between the chlorophyll dye of the leaf and the photons having maximum energy incident from the sun. So our collector should be colored green, dark green, like the colors of the leaves. This is the color for the discs collecting solar energy. So putting all of these concepts together, we need to have rings. We have a larger ring at the bottom, smaller one as we go upward. We have a central collector, and each ring will have these circular discs collecting solar energy, and they should be shifted, making a helical pattern of the discs on top of the discs and the rings. So this is the basic idea for a collector from the Quran. So I showed here, brothers and sisters, how by pondering upon the Quran, how Allah teaches us an optimal design for a solar collector. Now the next step I need to do is to build this collector physically. And I welcome any help from you. if you have the means to help me in this regard, I welcome your help. So I need to build it physically and compare its efficiency with present designs. And it will be shown, Allah God willing, that the efficiency of this collector, as learned from the Quran, would be much higher than anything known today. And again, I welcome your help. I welcome any help you can offer to build this physically, to help me to build it physically. And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com, and you can email me at zquran@gmail.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.